Hello everyone, so in this lecture we'll see one LAN technology, that is Ethernet. Okay guys, so let us begin with some LAN technologies. So in LAN technologies we can say that first one is known as, that is Ethernet. And second one is token ring, isn't it? So these are in the GATE syllabus. First one is Ethernet and second one is token ring, isn't it? So what is the meaning of LAN technologies? LAN means, we can say that, how the systems are going to be connected and which technology is used, isn't it? Let's say in your college campus, if you are going to make any LAN, local area network, then which technology is used and how the systems get connected. Okay, so that comes under LAN technology. So first one will see what is Ethernet and second one will see what is token ring, isn't it? So yes, in this lecture we'll see what is Ethernet. So this LAN technology, we can say that if we see IEEE documentation, then it is mentioned in IEEE 802.3 document, isn't it? So first one we'll see what is the Ethernet frame format. First one we'll see, means in this technology, what is the frame format? Frame means a data link layer. Data link layer deals at, yes, we can say that LAN environment, isn't it? So what is the, we can say that in the LAN environment, any message or we can say that data is known as what? Frame, isn't it? Okay, so what will be the frame format inside this technology, that is Ethernet? We'll see one by one, isn't it? So we can say that this one is what? This is one LAN technology, local area network LAN technology, isn't it? Okay, so frame format, let me see once what is the frame format. Yes, this is the frame. Yes, so we can say that, yes, any a packet, or we can say that inside data link layer is known as what? Frame. So first field is preamble. Preamble. Second one is SFD, start frame delimiter. Then destination address. Then source address. Then length field. Then data field. And last one is CRC. Isn't it? CRC is error detection method. So guys, remember, I already told you, once any data is transmitted from application layer to last layer, physical layer, so every layer will add some, or we can say that its own header, isn't it? Okay, so here we can say that this part, preamble and SFD, this header is, this particular header is added by physical layer, isn't it? Physical layer. So we can say that first data will come to data link layer, after that it will go to the physical layer. Yes, application layer too, we can say that transport layer, then network layer, then data link layer, then physical layer. So this part is added at the physical layer. So we can say that, yes, this is the header that is added by data link layer. Header added by data link layer. DLL stands for data link layer. And this CRC is also added at the, we can say that, data link layer at the tail. Why it is added at the tail? Yes, we can say that, yes, once the data, yes, is, we can say that, moving in the data link layer and parallelly CRC will be calculated, and once it is calculated, that will be added at the tail, isn't it? That is the logic behind that, isn't it? CRC will be calculated for the entire frame. Once it is calculated, then at last in the tail CRC will be added, isn't it? So yes, a data link layer, or we can say that LAN environment. In the LAN environment, data link layer, yes, will be there. So data link layer will add this destination address and source address. So these are the, we can say that, yes, MAC addresses, isn't it? MAC addresses or physical addresses. Upper layer in network layer, yes, destination address and source address are also added. Those are the IP addresses. In the upper layer, network layer header, yes, destination address and source address are added, in which port address will be there, isn't it? Okay. So yes, here we can say that MAC address is of 6 bytes, 48 bits. So this one will be of 6 bytes. This is also 6 bytes, isn't it? Okay. CRC is of 4 bytes, isn't it? Okay. Now we'll see. Yes, what is the, yes, we can say that SFD and preamble, isn't it? We'll see what is preamble and SFD. So I already told you during the, yes, we can say that, yes, introduction of physical layer, we can say that SFD is added for start for frame delimiter. Start frame delimiter indicates the starting of frame. So SFD is what? Some special pattern of bits, that is 10 10 10, and at last that is 11. So this will indicate that the frame is coming, but there is a chance that the SFD can match with the frame also, isn't it, or data also. So later on preamble is also added. So preamble is also added. So format of preamble is what? 10 10 10 10, and at last 10. So that is of 7 bytes, isn't it? 10 10 10, and at last that is, yes, that is 10 10 10. So we can say that that is of 7 bytes, isn't it? So SFD size is small, so there may be a possibility that SFD can match with data. So at later preamble is also added, isn't it? So preamble and SFD will indicate the start of the frame, that frame is coming. Once SFD is over, then yes, the frame will be, we can say that, yes, accepted or read by the destination, isn't it? So preamble is of 7 bytes and SFD is of 1 byte. These are added at later at physical layer, isn't it? Then the frame will be transmitted, isn't it? Okay. Now next one is, we can say that, let's say here destination address is of 6 bytes, source address is of also 6 bytes, because these are the MAC addresses or physical addresses, and MAC addresses are of 48 bits. Now we'll see, yes, length bit is of, we can say that length field is of, yes, that field is of 2 bytes, isn't it? Isn't it? So length field is of 2 bytes. That means we can say that this is of 16 bits, isn't it? Now remember guys, these header entire along with CRC and data, this is known as what? Frame, isn't it? From destination address to CRC, that is entire, this one is known as frame, in which actual data will be there. This is the actual data, isn't it? Okay. So we can say that here length field indicates, length field is of 16 bits. Length field indicates what? Size of data. Size of data. So you will say, yes, maximum data size will be 2^16 byte, but that is not correct, because some we can say that limitation of Ethernet are there. So maximum data size 2^16, that is not allowed. But maximum length field is of 16 bits, isn't it? So we seen CSMA CD, isn't it? Already seen CSMA CD. There we seen length of the, Yes, we can say that frame is greater than equals to twice of propagation time into bandwidth. After putting these values in the Ethernet, we can say that some bandwidth will be there in the Ethernet, some propagation time will be there in the Ethernet. So after putting these value, so minimum frame size is coming to be, that is 64 bytes, isn't it? Minimum frame size is of 64 bytes. That means what? That means we can say that, yes, this particular part, yes, you only tell me this one, from destination to CRC, this minimum frame size is what? 64 bytes, isn't it? Minimum size. From destination address to CRC, isn't it? Okay. One more thing, yes, we can say that, yes, we can say that maximum data size in the Ethernet, maximum data size in the Ethernet that is allowed is 1500 bytes only. So we can say that this particular maximum data size is how much? 1500 bytes in the Ethernet. That is allowed, isn't it? So yes, we can say that here, if we take the minimum size and maximum size, isn't it, for which, yes, what is the minimum size for data? And what is the minimum and maximum size for frame? So you know, minimum frame size is how much? 64 bytes. So we seen destination address, then source address, then length field, then data, and then finally is CRC. So this is entire frame. So here, this field of 6 bytes, this is of 6 bytes, this is of 2 bytes, this is of 4 bytes, isn't it? So frame, minimum frame size is 64 bytes, isn't it? So what will be the minimum data size? 64 minus 6 plus 6 plus 2 plus 4, that is 18. So 64 minus 18, that is 46 bytes. That means minimum size of this data that is allowed in the Ethernet is of 46 bytes, isn't it? You can remember in this manner, minimum size is 64, so just flip 4 and 6, then it is going to be 46. Now, yes, maximum data size that is allowed, that is 1500 bytes. So what will be the maximum frame size? Yes, 1500 plus header size. So here header is of 18 bytes, so 1518 bytes will be the maximum frame size allowed inside the Ethernet. Isn't it? Frame means what? Data plus header, everything, destination address, source address, length, CRC, all these comes under header. Isn't it? Actual data is data, that is minimum 46 byte and maximum 1500 byte. Isn't it? So that's all about, we can say that nothing more will be asked to you guys in the gate examination. So you can, yes, remember this format and you can remember what is the minimum and maximum data size and frame size inside the Ethernet. Isn't it? Okay guys, I hope this one is clear to everyone. In the next lecture, we'll see about token ring. Thank you so much.